In 2012, Cumberland Regional High School, funded in part by the National Endowment for the Arts and the New Jersey State Council of the Arts, began an artist-in-residence program with J. Kenneth Leap, a stained glass artist, to design stained glass panels for the entrance to the Performing Arts Center. The design reflects the stories and cultures of various communities residing in Cumberland County, New Jersey.
This residency that was implemented with Ken Leap in the school is a part of a bigger initiative which is called Folk Arts in Education, and there will be 5 residences altogether throughout the state of New Jersey. It's also a part of infrastructure projects connecting all the folk life centers in the state of New Jersey, and we are part of this infrastructure. So we work with folk and traditional arts, and we asked Ken Leap to teach them the very traditional art of medieval painting on glass, and this is how the residency began. It's a whole semester, 20-day residency program. It's about to end in a very, very successful way.
My favorite part of the glass project would have had to been the gathering of all the images and the initial research that went into the piece. I've lived in Cumberland County for the 18 years I've been alive, and I never realized that we had so many unique landmarks and that we were such a culture-rich area. I always thought it was just farmland and nothing else. So I found it really interesting to find out how much history is actually in this area. Like, the piece I chose was the Palace of Depression that resides in Vineland. It was designed as a palace made out of trash and leftover pieces in a dump. Unfortunately, it's no longer standing, but to find that there was actually a piece of history like that in this area is very unique to me, and to have it displayed on a piece in our school for many future generations to see is an honor.
When I was asked to choose an image to represent Cumberland County for this project, I chose the chief of my native tribe. And the picture that was given to me was a really awesome shot of him just in his tribal gear at a powwow. And I thought that really represented the tribe as a whole. We also chose to use the logo right next to him to really just drive the point home. I think that all the pieces that were chosen to be a part of this glass project really encompass all the areas that Cumberland County has to offer. And I really am glad for the opportunity that we were able to have with Mr. Leap and Ms. Tasker, Ms. Gates, and all the artists here.
My job as the artist involved with the piece was to then take this imagery that the students had created and drawn, and then weave it together to create the layout or the design for the panels. Also during the process, I taught the students the background about glass painting, which is my specific art form that I work in. Glass painting is a facet of stained glass that goes back to the way that stained glass windows were made during the Middle Ages. And it involves taking a glass-based pigment that you then paint onto pieces of glass, usually colored glass, and then painting with black to shade and model. And then these pieces of glass are put into a kiln and fired. At that point, the pigment that's in the paint fuses permanently to the surface of the glass, and you get a very long-lived product. So if we look back at the windows from the Middle Ages, where you'll see glass painting is often in the faces of the figures, the folds of their drapery, if there are inscriptions in the windows, it's all done using that glass painting technique. And glass painting is a process that not many people really know about, so it was really a privilege that I had to be able to share that with a very interested group of young people.
When I first started this project, I had no idea what was involved with stained glass. My experience with Mr. Leap was amazing and eye-opening. We did everything from picking the images to incorporating all the aspects of Cumberland County. He taught us how to mix and make the paint, and we even had the privilege to visit his studio and learn how to putty the frames. Both of my art teachers, Mrs. Wiley and Mrs. Tasker, greatly prepared me for this project through still life studies and lots of practice with paint. Overall, it was a really enjoyable experience that I learned a lot from, and am very happy to have been a part of it.
I visited Cumberland Regional over really a 10-week period, and during those sessions, I taught the kids how to paint on glass and the various processes that involves, because glass painting has both an additive and a subtractive process. So we painted first wet onto the glass, and then we did another process to create the shading, where the whole surface of the glass was covered with pigment, and then almost in a drawing process, you remove the pigment to create the shading. So the imagery that the students had sourced and I helped to lay out, they then rendered with the glass painted pigments. I brought them back here to my studio at Wheaton Arts and fired them in a kiln. And then the process involved really shuttling the glass back and forth a few times to the school for other stages to do.
My favorite part of the project was working with Mr. Leap. He's a very talented artist, and he's taught us so much about the history and the chemistry of stained glass painting. This project taught me to work with new mediums, and it helped me become a more diverse artist. I designed part of the river that flows through the window. I feel like it really brings the whole piece together.
One of the really great suggestions that came up through the art teachers that I had the privilege to work with was to include the image of the Cohansie River to tie all of those images together, and we decided to render that using a blue enamel. So that was another painting process that involved some an additional application of paint and an additional firing. So there are a couple of people that I would like to thank. First off is the New Jersey State Council on the Arts and Wheaton Arts, who worked together to help to bring me into the project. And I think one of the things that was really quite an unexpected kind of a delight was getting to work with Mrs. Tasker and Mrs. Gates and Mrs. Wiley, who were the art teachers that were involved with this project at Cumberland Regional. And I think we really, you know, hit it off, and we both enjoyed the opportunity to work together on really a nice kind of professional collaboration. The students were incredible. Everyone worked really hard, and it was you know, gratifying to see how much they embraced and bought into the project, and how much of their time they invested in it. Over the course of this project, I did very little beside really directing them in terms of how to do the process and creating sort of the technical support and background to help all the panels come together. I also wanted to really thank the administration that was so supportive. You know, Mr. McGraw and Mr. Mitchell couldn't have been better. They were very enthusiastic about this project and really acted as support in the background to make it all come together. So one of the things that really justifies all the time that you'll see that we've put into this piece is that'll be balanced by the fact of how long it will last. So that's one of the things about this particular art form that I find the most gratifying. Your students had a chance to go up and look at panels at the Cloisters in New York City, the Metropolitan Museum of Art, and they got to see examples of glass painting from the Renaissance, from the Middle Ages, you know, panels approaching nearly 1,000 years old. And that kind of legacy and that kind of story about a community can really be captured in this particular art form. And that's what, as a team, we really worked to do with these, you know, history and folklife panels that we've created for your Performing Arts Center. So I hope that it reflects the pride that you should all have in your community, the areas of the natural landscape that deserve to be preserved for future generations, and you know, just the tribute of the handwork of the students and the faculty who worked together to put this piece together. So I hope you enjoy it.